This video is about the internal noise source that powers Strange's generative algorithm, how it affects Strange's behavior, and how it can be used as a powerful noise source in its own right. The Strange algorithm is a specially adapted random walk, which, unlike standard sample and hold noise, offsets every event by a random amount from the last, producing a linear form of randomness perfectly suited to melodic generation. We've already explored how the main row and delta controls affect this in their own video. Here, we're going to look specifically at the noise source itself as it sits at the very heart of the algorithm. And throughout, I'm going to crossfade manually between the main CV out controlling an FM sound and Strange's dedicated noise output. All the noise functions are controlled by the A-sharp key, and it defaults to full-range 20 kHz white noise to accommodate external filter sweeping. However, holding A-sharp and X changes the internal noise sample rate. While perfect for creating gnarly digital noise effects, as with all of Strange's noise functions, this also fundamentally changes the character of the main algorithm. The yellow trace shows the noise feeding the algorithm, and the green is the output of the algorithm itself. The noise sample rate is completely independent from Strange's clock, and at this very low sample rate, the noise steps from one random value to another. At present, there are a lot of possible values, but holding A sharp and Y reduces the noise bit depth from 16 bits to 1, random gates. Notice how we have some delta dialed in. At high noise rates, the algorithm would jump randomly at each clock. But here, with the clock rate now faster than the noise, the same random value gets applied again and again for each clock until it changes to a new random value. Now let's mix things up even more by changing the fundamental nature of the noise. First, I bring the sample rate and bit depth back up. And now I take A sharp and Z past new to switch to pring noise, an exclusive or linear feedback shift register pseudo random number generator. This is how old 8-bit computers used to generate randomness. It's far from technically perfect because the values loop, but they're very characterful. And they produce fascinating self-looping sequences in the algorithm. This is perfect for chiptune-style work, and between the sample rate and bit depth controls offers another universe of random exploration to enjoy. Better still, there isn't just one pring. Settings past noon tap off different points of the analog shift register to provide a whole family of unique digital noise types. Another part of the make noise maths for random concept of Strange's design is self-patching. We've explored the effect of internal noise routing on the algorithm. Self-patching from its external noise output back into the external input changes the behavior yet again. Now the algorithm directly tracks the noise signal rather than being randomly offset by it. Let's finish up by upping the FM amount on the external VCO to full Buchla Bongo level. We'll also listen to just the algorithm output as affected by the settings rather than the noise itself to create a more kinetic, abstract piece. Thank you. change how the noise shifts the loop. We can add some stagger to put movement into the clock and make the tempi ebb and flow. And we have a completely distinct style of randomness coming out of Strange, offering you a whole alternative set of compositional and sound design approaches to the more standard methodologies we've explored in other videos. Thank you.